Hi there, my name is Alana and I use my YouTube channel to justify my crippling addiction to Charlotte Tilbury makeup products. Okay, maybe that is a little bit of an exaggeration, but here on Classy on the Run, we love talking about high-end and luxury makeup and handbags, and we absolutely love talking about Charlotte Tilbury. I've been working over the last year to build a library of Charlotte Tilbury content so that way I can answer any Charlotte question you may have, whether it's alternative products, you're looking for a swatch or a review. So I'm going to leave my playlist linked down below. But today we are going to be swatching and trying on 7 different blushes from her Cheek to Chic collection. Now in this video, you will find arm swatches, but you're also going to find how it actually looks on my cheek with a full face of makeup. I'm going to start by just going over a quick product overview. So these are large blushes that have 2 colors in the pan. Generally speaking, there's a lighter color on the outside and a deeper color in the middle. Now sometimes the color in the middle is a blush, other times it's more of a blush topper or a highlighter. Now you're going to apply this product with your favorite blush brush. You're going to start by circling around and sort of buffing it into the general area where you'd apply your blush. Then you are going to tap in the middle and always tap it off. Just give it a little tap off because there is generally a more pigmented shade in the middle and you're going to pop that on the apple of your cheek. So now that we know how to apply the product, let's get into this 7 blush review. So let's start with my favorite Charlotte Tilbury blush, and that is First Love. This is actually one of the first Charlotte Tilbury products I ever fell in love with. Now I can understand that when you look at this blush, it doesn't look like much in the pan. It's really similar in a lot of ways, I think, to Tarte's Exposed, in that in the pan, it doesn't really look like much, but if you have a complexion similar to mine, on the cheek, it looks stunning. I love this blush because it is so easy to build up from something light to something more sculpting and a touch more intense. You can never really apply too much of this blush, which is great if you're someone who's newer to makeup or somebody with a little bit of a heavier hand. But what I just love about this blush is it is so understated. So if I'm going for a bolder look or a bolder eye and I'm just looking for a blush that can be a fantastic supporting character, a blush that is not trying to steal the spotlight, I can always rely on First Love. Inner, outer, and blended. Next, we have Sex on Fire. This blush probably has the biggest difference between the outer shade and the inner shade. This is described as a rosy blush, although personally I would describe it as a peachy rose. While the outer rim reminds me a lot of First Love, the inner shade really is a beautiful, beautiful pop of rose. Now, to be honest, looking at this blush, I always felt a little bit more intimidated by it, but I think it's because that inner shade is so much deeper. But on the cheek, you would not think that they're the same product. I really enjoy this one. This is another great blush if I'm looking for a blush that would be a supporting character. It does have a little bit more rosiness to it, but it really is very neutral, very understated, and really, really easy to work with. Inner, outer, and blended. So here we have First Love, and then here we have Sex on Fire. As you can see, First Love is a lot peachier than Sex on Fire. Sex on Fire is a little bit more rosy. But I think what's actually most interesting is that even though Sex on Fire looks so much deeper in the pan, it doesn't really look that way in the swatches. Next we have Pillow Talk, and of course the Pillow Talk line is arguably what has made Charlotte Tilbury so iconic. This is a 2-tone pink and champagne powder blush, where the exterior of the blush is a little bit more of a matte, but the interior is, honestly, I think of it more as a highlighter or a blush topper, but the interior of this blush, which is the blush I'm wearing today, has a beautiful, beautiful glow to it. Now, this blush definitely took some time for me to warm up to. I don't tend to reach for blushes that are this deep. As we've just gone over, I definitely prefer blushes in the sort of nudie pink zone, and I find that this rosy tone is a little deeper than I tend to go for. So when I'm using this blush, I like to go in with a really light hand and build it up piece by piece rather than going in too heavy or too fast all at once. Now we've added Pillow Talk to the swatch. So we have inner, outer, and blended. Next we have Love Glow. Love Glow is described as a 2-tone pearlescent pink blush. It has that beautiful shine and luminosity to it. It has that glow, but this is definitely a cooler, softer pink. Now I find this blush to be very flattering on my winter complexion. So that's the complexion I have right now at the time of filming, where I haven't had a chance to go out and get much of a glow. It gives me that I've just been out skiing in the Alps or playing in the snow and I've come inside and you've got just those like rosy pink cheeks that we just love in the winter. I think this is a really, really beautiful, soft, feminine blush. I think it brings a beautiful light and color to the cheeks. And again, this blush has quickly quickly become one of my favorites. We've added Love Glow, so inner, outer, and blended. And as you can see, Love Glow is the softest and brightest pink that we've experienced so far. Next, we have Ecstasy. Now, this is described as a peachy pink blush, although I find it is almost, although not quite, veering into that bronzer territory. It has just a little bit of warmth and luminosity to it, whereas the first two blushes that I've shared with you are matte. This truly is a luminous blush. It looks beautiful on the cheek. It brings a beautiful, beautiful glow, that kind of mottled glow that Charlotte Tilbury is so well known for. My favorite way to wear this blush is when I have a tan, but this blush with my summer complexion, or if you have a little bit more warmth in your skin tone, I think you are really going to enjoy this one. Again, this product, if I build it up with a little bit more bronzer on my face and just really lean into that sort of warm, sun-kissed look. Here we have the swatches for Ecstasy. We have the inner, the outer, and then blended together. Next we have Walk of No Shame. Now I have to be honest, the Walk of No Shame collection has always intimidated me. But last month I actually did a video where I wore the entire Walk of No Shame collection. And to my surprise, I found it was actually really, really beautiful altogether. I'd always sort of shied away from it because of its berry tone, but I actually really enjoyed it. So I'm going to leave that video linked down below. This is a berry tone blush, and while the inner shade is described as a champagne, I really think it's more of a gold, maybe even a light gold, but I think it's a little bit too deep and too warm to be described as champagne. My complexion, I find I have to go in with a very light hand, but if you have a medium or deeper complexion, I think you will really enjoy that blush. And here we have the swatches for Walk of No Shame. The inner, which is more of a blush topping highlighter, outer, and then blended together. And finally, we have Pillow Talk Intense. Pillow Talk Intense is described as a two-tone deep rosy pink powder blush. This is the deepest blush that I have from her in my collection, and I found that I had to go in with a really, really light hand. To be honest, I don't consider this blush to be particularly flattering on me and my complexion, but I did want to provide the swatches, of course, for the purpose of this video. And I actually originally received this blush as a gift with purchase on her website. So I wouldn't have gone out of my way to spend my money on this blush, but I'm definitely happy to have it in my collection for comparison purposes. I think, again, this is a wonderful blush if you have a medium or a deeper complexion. And what I think is really great is that she's taken Pillow Talk and included the Pillow Talk Intense line. That way people with deeper complexions are able to get that Pillow Talk glow that she's so well known for. Finally, we've added the deepest blush, which is Pillow Talk Intense. We have the inner, outer, and blended. And while in the pan, the inner looks more like a blush topper or a highlighter, on my complexion, I'd say you could use it as a blush. But perhaps for a deeper complexion, it would be a wonderful blush topper or highlighter. Now there is one powder blush from her that I don't have, and that is the Climax. The Climax is described as a two-tone reddy brown powder blush. Now to be honest, that description doesn't sound appealing for me and my complexion. So that is 7 out of the 8 Charlotte Tilbury Chic to Chic blushes, including swatches, a try-on, and a quick review. I hope you found this video helpful if you are trying to figure out which blush is the best one for you. I will say that if you have a complexion similar to mine, my two absolute favorites are First Love and Ecstasy. So I hope that this video is helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them down below and I'd be happy to answer. Thank you so much for watching. If you haven't already, please subscribe. Bye.